Military needs to be close to threat. This is from AdelaideNow.com, Australia. Rule number one with government reviews is never commission one if you don't already know the outcome. So it won't come as a surprise that some very powerful people believe that the nation's biggest Navy base no longer belongs in the middle of Sydney Harbor and that the bulk of our military assets should be closer to the actual threat. Every classified defense planning document for the past 30 years has named China as Australia's and America's military boogeyman. Combine that with the Indian Ocean status as the world's oil superhighway and India and Pakistan's nuclear weapons capability, then it is clear that Australia's big security challenges lie to our north and west. The discovery of vast oil and gas fields in the northwest of the continent also means that energy security is a much higher priority than a token military presence in or near the big city thousands of kilometers away. Having Navy bases on prime real estate around Sydney Harbor, Army barracks in rural Victoria, and Air Force bases on the outskirts of Sydney has become an expensive anomaly. Given that the majority of our military missions occur to the north and west, with the occasional adventure out to the islands to our east, having defense assets closer to the action and the country's energy resources makes sense. The big drawback will be attracting people to live and work in places such as Darwin, Cairns, Katherine, Port Hedland, Townsville, and even Mandurah near Perth, where Defense Minister Stephen Smith has his electorate. The government should brace itself for a vocal campaign from the multitude of special interest groups, including marginal seat MPs, who benefit from the defense dollars flowing into communities. Okay, I want to go back to another article. This is from the Herald Sun. Defense Minister Stephen Smith said a new review of the Defense Force's posture would ensure the Australian Defense Force was geographically positioned to meet emerging security and strategic challenges. That included the rise of the Indian Ocean Rim powers, the need to be able to respond to regional humanitarian disasters, and the emerging challenge of energy security. Mr. Smith said there was a prospect that more ships and aircraft would be based in Western Australia, the Northern Territory, and Northeast Queensland. As circumstances change, our posture needs to change too. Off the coast of the northwest of Western Australia and off the coast of the Northern Territory, we are now seeing a significant petroleum resources energy belt. Okay, let me see, then there was one other area that I wanted to go back to, and that was regarding the U.S. also regards Northern Australia as a vital link in its Asia-Pacific security chain, and Mr. Smith assured Australians that their great and powerful friend ain't going nowhere when it comes to security in the Asia-Pacific. So it does appear that China is trying to emerge here as the most powerful country, and the United States is trying to make some strategic moves. So it would appear, but I also did read that the United States military is sending its largest fleet ever to Australia, and I'm not seeing where that was. Okay, I'll find it, and I'll put it in the information area along with links to these so that you can see what I was talking about. Alrighty. Good day.